Hello guys and welcome to the video. In this video, as you have already seen in the thumbnail, I'm gonna make sure that after watching this video, you will be able to know your CPU benchmarks. So I'll be using Cinebench R23 in this video to measure the CPU multi-core as well as single core scores. So without wasting any further time, let's jump straight into the video. First of all, we will use Cinebench R23 software. So for that, you can either search on your Microsoft Store or you can simply, as I'll show you, Cinebench R23. Just after you type Cinebench, you will get this first option called Cinebench app, which is nothing but Cinebench R23 itself. Let it open. So as you can see, this is powered by Maxon computers. You can see Cinebench R23. Either you can download it from here by just clicking on this install button, or you can simply go to your any of the browsers and then simply search Cinebench R23. You will get this Maxon.net, same as the Microsoft one. This was also from Maxon computers, and this is also the same. So either you can download it from the web or you can download it from the Microsoft Store itself. I'm going to download it from the Microsoft Store, so I'll just click on install. So my download has been started, as you can see here, Cinebench. It's downloading, and if you download it from here, you'll also get a zip file. Then you will have to extract that file. Let me show that also. It is of 280 MB. First one is for Windows and the second is for macOS. So if you are using a Mac, then you can simply download this one, and if you are using Windows, you will have this option for install for Windows, or either you can download it from here. So I'm downloading for my Windows laptop. So you can see here, it is downloading from the Microsoft Store, and just wait for it to download. So before launching this Cinebench R23 and checking our CPU single core and multi core scores, I'll just show you what type of CPU and how many cores are there in my laptop. So as you can see, I have a Intel Core i5-8250U CPU, which is clocked at 1.6 GHz, and it has 4 cores and 8 threads, right? So this you can also see in your computer as well. So I'll just keep this in mind that I have i5 8th generation, which is 8250U CPU. So let us also open this software up. I'm gonna close all of the windows to get the maximum performance. So I'll just simply open this application. So let this launch. This is the first window, and this is the agreement. Just simply accept this. At the left side, you can see this CPU multi-core and the CPU single core. And this is the MP ratio, which is the ratio of both a CPU multi-core and CPU single core scores. So here also you can see it has detected that I have i5 8th generation this model CPU, and it has 4 cores and 8 threads, and it is clocked at this gigahertz, and I am using Windows 10 Professional Edition. At the down, you can see these are the comparable CPUs to which my CPU also needs to be placed in these rankings. So let us check, and you can switch this for the multi-core, single core and MP ratios. You can also switch to single core scores. So you can see i7 11th generation gives 1532 points in the single core test, and the multi-core, if I see here, this is the Ryzen Threadripper 2900WX, which is giving 30,054 points for the multi-core score. So we have to measure our system's points also. So just click on this CPU multi-core and just start it. So I have just clicked on this start. So as you can see, this is running and I have set it to 10 minutes. This will stress your all the cores to render this image. So it has already started the rendering process. So as you can see, it will last till 10 minutes. So this will take 10 minutes and then after it will give you your single core scores right here. So I'm just stopping it right now. For checking your single core scores, you will just have to click on this single core start. Just click on this start button and then it will just start measuring your single core scores. So I'll not run the CPU benchmarks right now because I am also using a screen recorder in the background. So it might affect the actual points my system would get. So for the fair checking, I have already measured my CPU's single core as well as multi-core scores. So I'll show you the results. As you can see, I have tested my single cores as well as multi-core scores. So this was mine ranking, my system's ranking, which was Intel Core i5-8250 CPU. And I got in the single core scores, I got 898 points, which was below this Ryzen Threadripper 1950X. So let me clear one thing. If you check more than one time, you might get different results, but it won't vary much. It will be a little bit of difference based on the background softwares you are opening, the age of your laptop or the PC which you are using. So this was my score, which was Intel i5-8250U CPU, and the multi-core score I got is 2448 points. And this is the ratio, which is 2.73x. By this, you can compare your CPU performance. So if you want to check that if your CPU is performing as per its standards or not. So if you want to check if your CPU is performing as per your standards or not, so you can compare your CPU model on the Google. So mine is i5-8250U CPU. So let us go and check how my CPU generally performs. So I'll just open my browser, right, and just I'll search. I'll just click Cinebench R23 to check the similar scores. So as you can see, this is some website called cpumonkey.com. Let us check. This was my CPU, right. It will give you some general scores which your CPU generally has. So let us check the average scores. Where is that? I think I have to scroll down a little more. So as you can see here, the single core score it says is 897, and if I check mine, I was getting, it is a single core 897 and I got single core 898. So it isn't varying that much. So you will get similar kind of results. If you are getting a way lower results, like around 100 points lower, then it might possible that your CPU is not performing as per its standards. So you can see if your CPU is undervolted. My CPU is performing well, I think. So as you have seen that I have got these scores. So same as you can also check your CPU's multi-core and single core scores. And one thing I would like to suggest, that before you start your benchmarking, make sure that you have plugged your laptop into the power source so that you can get the most out of the performance of your laptop. So make sure to plug in your PC before starting the test. So that was it for the video. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up, share among your friends, and subscribe to the channel. We'll meet in the next video.